because before you can have decent health, you need decent housing that's dry, which you feel psychologically secure, that you're not going to be threatened with eviction at any point. And then you can have some health. When your health is good, you're then able to take part in education in that order. So until such time as we have a decent program for building homes, not this affordable homes business when it's an ambiguous statement that doesn't really mean anything, but proper publicly funded homes, just as we publicly fund the National Health Service and education, even if those two are currently being publicly funded inadequately, we need all three to be funded properly. Talk among yourselves. Yeah, this bedroom tax too, it's just simply another punitive cut, another barrier to a decent life. However hard the Robertos and Bob Cratchits of the 21st century work, they'll never get out of the dip as long as measures like this are taken. It's purely punitive, and it only takes an unforeseen social crisis at home, like losing a job, a sudden illness, an accident, or the bedroom tax, and you too could believe that what the Tories call the jams just about managed it, and then you won't be managing it at all. The bedroom tax is one of those cuts that could and will be a tipping point for many people. So I know that previous speakers have gone into some detail about this tax. So just let us remember, the Tories say that it's to help homelessness. The most forgotten group in all of this is the single homeless male, who are particularly ignored in a world that obviously doesn't care about homelessness, evidently does not care, as the single males are often not classed as vulnerable compared to their sisters, who by definition the males by definition don't have vulnerable children to look after. So somehow, because they don't have children, they just get ignored and left to the bottom of the pile. I think this is very unfortunate and needs to be addressed. Also, we do not to build smaller houses to allow compliance with a bedroom tax. What we need is a scrapping of this evil bedroom tax 1 and evil bedroom tax 2. What is needed is the building of decent family homes on a massive scale, publicly funded. And, I mean, it's just crazy. What a waste. Think of the money that would be spent on a temporary accommodation, and then people have to go through some weird process to eventually get home again. It's absolutely crazy. Yes. Anyway, it's time for change. The housing market has been failing for decades. We're always talking about the housing crisis, acute, chronic. So, basically we need to build equity with public housing and basically, as I said before, these things need to be funded properly. This nonsense about the market and this feverish notion of being a homeowner so that you can have a mortgage. That lady said she was from France. Mortgage is French. It means it hangs on your neck till you die, unless you're lucky enough to pay it off in 25 years. Many people don't manage that. They die before it's paid. This is about human rights. What could be more basic than the right to live in a decent, warm home without living in fear? Thank you.
Whoa. Well done.
Right. We're just going to wind up in a minute or two. But I just want to say, finally, and I'll introduce you just to say something about a young man who basically took his own life because his housing benefit, his benefits were taken off him. But I have to say, these people over here, the Scottish Tory branch office of Theresa May's government, the rich, vile, Robert Barron government, these people over here only represent the rich and the powerful. They only represent the rich elite. We are here today to bear witness that working class people will fight back and will not allow this second bedroom tax to take place, because Scottish civic society will not allow it to happen.